Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Gated SR Latches. Okay, for us to understand a gated SR latch, we've got to at least have an understanding of how a basic SR latch works. All right, we have already discovered some flaws with a basic SR latch. Namely, there are invalid regions where if you try to simultaneously set and reset something, you'll end up with an invalid mode. And due to what's known as a race condition, sometimes our output queue as a result of an invalid condition, we could have unpredictable output. So we want to solve some of these things, some of these issues. And in addition to that, the invalid too, we're using active low, which makes people's heads explode. So what we're going to try to do is solve both of these issues, the invalid and the active low, by putting what's called steering gates on the front of this basic SR latch. And the whole purpose of the steering gates is two things. Get rid of the active low, major advantage, less head explosion. And number two, put a enable signal on this thing. How would I invert those active low signals, not S and not R, to just make them S and R? Well, probably what I would do is put an inverter on it, but I want to put them in combination with an enable. So how I would do that is I would do this pretty simple addition to the front of a basic SR latch, and it does both things simultaneously. And that is my steering gate combinations. All it is, it's two more NAND gates added to the front of a basic SR latch. And if you could think about this, enable. When enable is a zero, can there be any output for either of those two NAND gates, which I'm referring to as this one and this one, other than a one? And the answer is no. You will never get an active low S or an active low R to your basic SR latch if enable is a zero, okay? However, if enable is a one, and let's say, for example, S is a one, what we are is in this condition right there. What is the output to the active low S, i.e. not S, it's a zero. So when an enable signal exists, it inverts that S input to an active low input, not S. Do the exact same thing for R. If there is an enable signal, one, and there is an active high, one, on R, what do I get? This exact same section of the truth table right here. I am sending an active low output zero to not R. And how does that basic SR latch behave? The exact same way when it's enabled. The key is, yes, there is still an invalid section. I can never simultaneously set and reset the basic SR latch. However, I've got this enable signal to potentially filter out those times when I'm trying to simultaneously set and reset. And the way you can think about this is your gated SR latch has three inputs now. Basic SR latch still has two inputs, and it's still going to behave exactly like I've got in that yellow box. But your gated SR latch has three inputs. S, active high, i.e. set it when it's a 1. R, active high, i.e. reset it when it's a 1. And enable, turn it off if it's a 0. Don't do nothing. Turn it on if it's a 1. Listen to the inputs, S and R. So what we can do is create a truth table based off three inputs. And it's going to look something like this. And there are three inputs, all eight possible combinations of input. And just think in terms of mode now. What mode am I in when enable is 0, set is 0, and reset is 0? It doesn't matter what S and R is. Enable is 0. It's off. Okay, the whole thing is off. Okay, and what this could really kind of be considered, if it's not accepting input from S and R, it could really kind of be defined as a memory state again. And all four of those first initial conditions are memory. It's not enabled. You can call it disabled or memory states. Okay, now let's go here. Enable is a one. We are turning on this device. However, we are neither setting it nor resetting it. What do you think would happen? Well, it would probably be also in a memory state. Before I write down the mode, however, you can even think about this in terms of that basic SR latch. If enable is a 1 and set is a zero and reset is a zero, what are the outputs for those two steering gates? Well, I'm currently in a condition of 0, 1. Let me get rid of this scrolling right here. I'm currently in a condition of 0, 1 for the top NAND gate, and I'm going to have a 1 output there. For the bottom NAND gate, I'm in a condition of 1, 0, and I've got a 1 output there. Where are we at for basic SR latch? Right there, exact same description, is we are neither setting it nor resetting it. So let's get rid of this. So we are neither setting it nor resetting it. And what does that enable really kind of acting like? Well, if you've got a 1 on the enable, it's inverting that initial S or R input so it becomes active low for the basic SR latch, which requires active low inputs, not S and not R. But it's kind of a waste of our time to think that way even anymore, because really this is a 3-input device. So you can kind of even get rid of the description of that basic SR latch and just start thinking in terms of a gated SR latch. What happens in this condition here when it is enabled? I am not setting it, but I am resetting it. What happens now? I am enabling it. I am setting it. I am not resetting it. And the one we had previously just discussed, which we already determined was a memory state, just think of in terms of modes. I am enabling it. I am not setting it. I am not resetting it. It's in a memory mode. So obviously, when I enable it, I am not setting it. I am resetting it. What am I going to do? I'm going to be in reset. I am enabling it. I am setting it. I am not resetting it. I'm setting it. Finally, what is this last condition? This is the last condition you probably want to avoid because it's this one. You are enabling it and you are simultaneously setting and resetting it. It's still invalid. You still ran your car off the road, but think about it. You got a 1 in 8 chance of running your car off the road versus a 1 in 4 chance of running off the road. Okay, so now we haven't even really talked about what is the output cue. And again, just think of the modes. Think of the modes. I can just get rid of all that gobbledygook that I've drawn up there with those cross-coupled NAND gates, with those steering gates, and just seriously just replace it with a box. And based off the descriptions of those modes, I can figure out what Q and not Q look like. And here's the box where it's got an S input. It's got an enable input. How do I know it's active high? Because there's no modifiers to it, i.e. there's no carrots or bubbles to it. I've got an R input, I've got a Q output, and if I wanted to be tricky, I could actually have that not Q output also available. And how do I differentiate between not Q and Q? Well, I could put the name on it, or I could put that little bubble on it. How does the device in the box behave? Well, when enable is 0, Q has its prior input. It's either it's in a memory state. When enable is a 1, and I'm neither setting nor resetting, what happens? Q is in its memory state. It has its prior input on it. When I'm enabling it and I am setting it, when I'm enabling it and I am resetting it, what does Q do? Well, it goes to 0. I am enabling it. I am setting it. What does Q do? It goes to 1. It sets. And finally, I'm enabling it. I'm simultaneously setting and resetting it. What does it do? It explodes. Okay, it doesn't actually explode. Q and not Q simultaneously go to 1, which doesn't make sense. It's an invalid condition. Don't do it. What could the output Q be? Well, if it's in memory, it's what was in there previously. I can call that Q0. I don't necessarily like that, although you see that in data sheets because, you know, we're going to be doing multiple stages of these things, but you can think it's just prior. Okay, what is reset? When it's in reset mode, Q should go to 0 regardless of where it was. If it was a 1, it goes to 0. If it was a 0, it stays a 0. Now it's in set mode. It's enabled and being set. Regardless of what it was, it goes to a 1. Okay? If it was a 0, it goes to a 1. If it's a 1, it stays a 1. Finally, in our invalid region, what does Q go to? Well, it goes to 1, but I'm going to put invalid because not Q also goes to 1. And again, when you remove those conditions, you're going to get that race condition where you could potentially have unknown data. That being said, if you have an unknown condition, you enable it again and then reset it. What's it going to be? It's going to be 0. Or you enable it again and you set it. What's it going to be? It's going to be a 1. Okay, so even though you may enter an invalid or an unknown condition, you can always snap out of it. Just slap it across the face and say, hey, mister, reset. How are we going to talk about gated SR latches? We're going to talk about these things with timing diagrams, just like we did with our combinational logic. logic inputs. What I can do is I can put enable S and R on a timing diagram. And based off those inputs, I should be able to determine how Q behaves. However, I need to give you initial conditions. I need to tell you, okay, Q, when you get this thing, it lays down on your desk, there is a zero on it, or there is a one on it. However, even if you didn't have initial conditions, what you could do is just kind of put those crosshatches, i.e. unknown, and then when you get your first reset, you can take it from there. Or when you get your first valid set, you can take it from there. Okay, so let's try a timing diagram example for gated SR latches.